Hi, I'm going to show you how to preprocess text using NLTK. First, if you don't have NLTK installed, you can install it by running pip install NLTK. I already have it, so I'm going to skip this step. We also have this text file that I'm going to show you how to preprocess. The first thing we're going to do is open that file in Python by calling open. The first method we're going to look at is tokenization. What tokenization does is break down text into smaller units called tokens, which can be words, sentences, or even individual characters. To do this, we import sendTokenize from NLTK. sendTokenize takes a string and returns a list of sentences. If I tokenize a string, "I went to the UK, it was okay," it returns the two sentences. But it is sensitive to features like capitalization and some other uncommon uses of punctuation. So it's not perfect, but it's still a lot better than just splitting the string on end punctuation. So let's get the sentences. We'll build a list by calling sendTokenize. Each entry in the list is a sentence. Now to get each word. For this, we import wordTokenize. Now we're going to go through each sentence, and we're going to call wordTokenize. Each sentence in sentences is now a list of words. Notice that punctuation that separates words, like commas and periods, are also considered words. A stop word is a word that occurs frequently without providing much useful information. Examples are words like the, and is, and. We usually remove these because it makes the data smaller and easier to work with. It can also make some NLP tasks more accurate, depending on the task. First, we need to import NLTK. We also need to import stop words from nltk.corpus. If this is the first time we're running this, we need to download the stop words. In order to filter out the stop words, we'll create a function to check whether a word is not in the stop word list. We'll go through a for loop, and for each sentence, we'll apply that filter function, which gets rid of the stop words, and will print the sentence. Here's each sentence. Notice that there are no words like the or is. Before we move on, remember that depending on your use case, you may want to keep some of the words in NLTK's stop word list, or you may want to get rid of more. You can always use a different list of words. The next preprocessing method is stemming. Stemming is when you reduce a word to its root or stem. As an example, the stem of going is go. We do this if the NLP task we do later wants us to treat the inflected forms the same. First, from nltk.stem, we import Porter Stemmer. There are other stemmers with different algorithms. This is one of the most popular ones. Now we create a stemmer object. To stem a word, pass the word to the stemmer's stem function. We'll do this for each word. Here are the pairs of sentences with the original on top and the stemmed on the bottom. Things like plurals are removed. Notice how the stemmer does not work perfectly, so be aware of that. None of the stemmers work perfectly. One of the benefits of a stemmer over looking up the inflected forms in a dictionary is that a stemmer works with unknown words. Next is lemmatization. Lemmatization is replacing words with the basic dictionary form. The difference between lemmatization and stemming is that stemming is about finding what stem the other parts of the word were added onto, whereas lemmatization is about finding the original word based on the meaning of the word being lemmatized. The stem of going is go because ing is added to go. The lemma of going is also go because the meaning of going is a derivation of the meaning of go. But the stem of went is went, because went doesn't have anything added to it. But the lemma of went is also go, because the meaning of went is derived from the meaning of go. The process is almost the same as stemming, but you may need to download some files for NLTK to use. First, we import the lemmatizer. From nltk.stem, import wordnet lemmatizer. Then, we create the lemmatizer object. To lemmatize a word, pass in the word to the lemmatizer's lemmatize function. For every sentence, we'll do this for every word. Now we'll print the results. Unlike stems, each lemmatized word is an actual word, because this lemmatizer looks up the words in a database called WordNet. To recap, tokenization is splitting text into smaller parts that are easier to work with. Stop word removal gets rid of words that are useless to us. Stemming and lemmatization map words to their original form. If you found this guide helpful, feel free to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.